As businesses has grown and evolved, managing and securing user identities across various systems and applications becomes increasingly complex. The stakes are high, with potential risks including data breaches, unauthorized access, and compliance violations. Identity governance becomes a critical challenge for organizations. Hi, I'm Arvind, and I'm a product manager at Microsoft. In this video, I'll provide a brief overview of how you can use Microsoft Entra ID Governance to help mitigate these risks and safeguard your organization's digital identity. At Microsoft, we believe that governance is more than just meeting your compliance requirements. When done right, identity governance can enable your organization to be more productive by streamlining application access, secure your organization by removing unnecessary access to resources, and help automate manual processes. Ultimately, identity governance can save your organization time, help to manage risk, and help your organization to be more productive. Microsoft's approach to identity governance provides a complete solution for identity and access management, identity governance administration, and multi-cloud permissions management. This includes governing all the identities in your organization and those that you partner with, including suppliers or vendors, and workload identities. Using a standards-based approach, Microsoft enables you to govern all of your applications and resources, whether they're SaaS apps developed by an independent software vendor, your line of business apps, or on-prem applications. And we want to enable you to manage and govern identities at scale. This means taking an API-first approach to product development and providing the necessary self-service and automatic policy-based features to deploy across your organization. Now let's look at the lifecycle of a user and how you can use Microsoft Entra ID Governance to manage the lifecycle of that user. The first step in the user journey typically starts in the human resources system of record. Just as many traditional services are modernizing to the cloud, this includes HR. Organizations using popular HR SaaS providers such as Workday and SuccessFactors can use the out-of-the-box integrations with Entra ID for both single sign-on and user provisioning. These integrations allow you to manage the entire lifecycle of the user, creates, updates, and disabling user accounts. This provides authoritative data that will enable you to do more advanced governance tasks, such as triggering workflows before the user starts or removing access when the user leaves the company. We want to enable you to manage and govern identities at scale. This means taking an API-first approach to product development. If your organization is not yet using one of these popular solutions, you can use the provisioning API to bring identities into your tenant from any HR system of record. Often, we've seen organizations export data from their HR systems into a central SQL database or use CSV files to bring identities into Entra. With the provisioning API, you can either directly bring identities into Entra ID or first create them in Active Directory before synchronizing them to the cloud. There are HR vendors that are actively building integrations with the provisioning API and system integrators and partners that are ready to help connect you with any HR system of record. With the provisioning API, you can integrate with one or more HR systems to bring all your identities into the tenant. While most organizations today are moving applications to the cloud and integrating new apps directly with Entra ID, users likely need access to apps integrated with Active Directory. Microsoft Entra ID Cloud Sync allows you to synchronize identities between Active Directory domain services and Entra ID. Using a lightweight agent, organizations can connect to disconnected forests and bring identities into the cloud. As you move workloads to the cloud and start managing resources such as groups natively in Entra ID, you can synchronize those groups back into on-premises Active Directory using Cloud Sync. Cloud Sync can be deployed either on its own or alongside Entra ID Connect Sync, allowing you to seamlessly transition from Entra ID Connect Sync to Cloud Sync over time. While most of the users in your tenant originate from your HR systems, your organization likely needs to collaborate with partner organizations. With Microsoft Entra External Identities, you can invite and collaborate with users outside of your organization and maintain access to your resources. These can be users and other Entra ID tenants, external identity providers, or users simply utilizing existing email or social logins. With Microsoft Entra ID Governance, you can govern the complete lifecycle of external users using the same capabilities that you use to manage your own users. Users are in Entra ID, you can now streamline the process to give them access to the resources they need. Most users will require access to applications such as your help desk system, payroll, and internal SharePoint. Based on their role as defined in the HR system, users will need further access to role-specific apps, either hosted on-premises or in the cloud. A new employee often spends the first week figuring out how to get access to these resources and waiting for approvals. With entitlement management, you can make the onboarding process seamless. You can define rules for which users should have access to which resource. For example, you might want to grant all users in the sales department access to Salesforce. Based on the data that you've imported into Entra from your HR system, you can automatically assign the necessary application. When someone changes roles, they'll automatically be granted access to the resources they now need, and unnecessary access will be removed. In cases where you need to define custom logic for granting access, you can integrate logic apps with Entra ID and use a low-code, no-code experience to define the rules needed to meet your business processes. When a user is granted access to an application, they often need an account provisioned before they can sign it. When entitlement management assigns a user access to an application Entra, the provisioning service can automatically create accounts for those users. With about 350 pre-integrated applications, support for any application with a SCIM endpoint, and on-prem apps that rely on SQL, LDAP, REST, SOAP, or even just CSV to provision and deprovision accounts, the provisioning service can integrate with just about any application that your organization uses. As users change departments and roles, the provisioning service keeps the identities in sync and deprovisions access when the user doesn't need it anymore. Now, in some cases, users may need access to resources that aren't granted automatically. Using entitlement management, you can define a request approval process for granting access to resources. You can define one or more approvers, and even trigger a logic app before or after approval of the resource. Access can be time limited. If a user needs to access a resource for a project that lasts a year, you can define the policies to manage the lifecycle of the user. The access packages can contain resources such as Microsoft Entra groups, teams, apps, SharePoint sites, and even roles. In each of an access package's policies, you can specify who is able to request that access package, such as all member users in your organization, or only users who are already a member of a particular group. However, you may wish to further restrict access in order to avoid a user from obtaining excessive access. With the separation of duties settings on an access package, you can configure that a user cannot request access to a package if they already have an assignment to another access package or are a member of a group. When employees need to collaborate with people outside the organization, they use Microsoft Entra ID to invite external users into their tenant. However, without a governance process, this can lead to hundreds or thousands of users in your tenant that shouldn't have access anymore. Using the Connected Organizations feature in Entitlement Management, you can define an access package and allow users from a connected organization to request access to those resources and ensure the necessary approvals are in place before granting access. If, for example, a vendor needs access for the duration of a contract, you can time limit that access and ensure that the access is both approved and periodically reviewed. When an external user doesn't need access anymore, entitlement management can automatically remove the account, ensuring that only the user that still needs access remains in your tenant. Over time, users may get assigned to admin roles and amass more and more admin privileges. What you really want is to provide just enough access and just in time for when it's needed. This helps reduce the user's risk profile, so even if a privileged user gets phished or attacked, the overall risk is vastly reduced. With Microsoft Entra Privileged Identity Management, you can provide just-in-time access to Entra ID, Microsoft 365, and Azure roles. You can provide just-in-time access to groups in Entra, allowing users to access privileged resources in non-Microsoft applications. These role activations are not only time-limited, but protected by conditional access. Now, when a user activates a role, it can trigger CA enforcement to apply authentication strengths, Intune compliance, third-party MFA, and location requirements. For example, an organization can now require FIDO2 authentication when activating a role for production Azure subscriptions in AWS accounts. As another example, location requirements can be enforced when activating membership in the group that provides access to sensitive applications. To meet your compliance requirements and ensure least privilege, performing periodic access reviews becomes an important part of governing your organization. With Entra ID access reviews, you can manage users assigned to groups, enterprise applications, access packages, and privilege roles to make sure they maintain a security standard. Regular oversight by the users themselves, resource owners, and other reviewers ensures that users don't retain access for extended periods of time when they no longer need it. Microsoft Entra ID access reviews is a policy-based access certification mechanism which can be used not just for Contoso's employees, but also for their guest users and privileged roles. With the growing trend of more applications and services moving to the cloud, it can also be used for non-human workload identities or service principles. To help reduce reviewer attestation fatigue, it provides intelligent recommendations. The approval workflows can be customized and multi-staged with multiple approvers. To gain more insight on access reviews or for audit and compliance needs, there's the possibility to download an access review history report. These reports can be constructed to include specific access reviews for a specific time frame and can be filtered to include different review types and review results. While performing reviews is important to meeting your compliance requirements and ensuring least privilege, it can lead to reviewer fatigue and users automatically approving access to resources. This is an area where we've invested in leveraging machine learning to make smart recommendations for reviewers and help them make better decisions on whose access to approve or deny. The access review service takes signals such as the sign-in activity, organizational reporting structure to make recommendations for each user. The user-to-group affiliation recommendation detects user affiliation with other users within the group based on the organization's reporting structure. We built a scoring mechanism that computes the statistical Z-score to identify the distance between the users in an organizational hierarchy to assess if the user's access needs to be retained or revoked. This ensures that the users who are distant from all the other users in the group are considered to have a low affiliation, and our system will then provide a deny recommendation. Ultimately, these machine learning investments will save end users time and help them make the right decisions to protect the organization. Now, when a user leaves the organization, Microsoft Entra ID Governance can ensure that access is removed across all apps the user has access to. The provisioning engine can import the change from the HR system, indicating the user has been terminated, and trigger a lifecycle workflow to offboard the user. This could include setting their account to inactive, deleting the account from the directory, and removing their access to applications. This provides IT admins and security teams peace of mind, knowing that user access is automatically revoked. Each step of the user journey can require work by help desk and IT to make sure the right people have access to the right resources. Now, let's look at how your organization can automate manual processes and save time. Onboarding and offboarding new users to any organization involves many moving parts. There are multiple workflows and processes that must be performed for a user to gain access to the resources they need. These have historically been manual processes. IT admins have had to rely on scripts to complete the onboarding process, and troubleshooting problems is a complex, time-consuming process. By automating these workflows, new employees can be onboarded quickly and be productive starting on day one. Similarly, termination tasks for departing employees are also time-consuming and inefficient and can leave app access with unused accounts. With workflows and templates for planned or real-time separation scenarios, IT admins and users can experience a secure and automated offboarding process. Lifecycle Workflows helps reduce manual and repetitive tasks by automating and streamlining the process to provide the right access and ensure productivity of employees on day one as the role changes within the organization and timely removal of access when users leave the organization. Lifecycle Workflows provides the ability to configure custom workflows to automate those manual processes associated with joiner, mover, and leaver scenarios for managing access based on changes to the employee lifecycle. The experience is easy to use with predefined tasks such as sending users a welcome email, a temporary access pass, assigning them licenses, and much more. When you need flexibility to define your own custom tasks, Lifecycle Workflows allows you to trigger a logic app, which can perform just about any action that you need. This could include a ServiceNow ticket, calling a REST API, or running a PowerShell script. And last but not least, your organization will need a clear audit trail to monitor activity in your tenant and assess whether and how you need to respond to potential issues. To meet compliance requirements, your organization will need easy and comprehensive reports. To support you with this goal, the Entra portal gives you access to three activity logs: sign-ins, information about sign-ins and how your resources are used by users; audit information about changes applied to your tenants, such as user and group management or updates to your tenants' resources; and provisioning activities performed by the provision service, such as the creation of a group in ServiceNow or a user imported from Workday. Entra ID retains the logs for 30 days for P1 and P2 customers, and you can retain the audit and sign-in activity data for longer than the data retention period by routing to the Azure storage account using Azure Monitor. This will not only enable you to retain data for a longer time, but also provide you rich visualizations using workbooks. There are several workbooks out of the box, but you can also create your own custom workbooks as well. Azure Monitor integration can also be used to stream data to scene tools like Microsoft Sentinel, Arc Insight, or Splunk. And that concludes this brief overview of Entra ID Governance. I hope that this provides you with the foundation you need to understand Microsoft's approach to ID governance and provides a brief overview of the current capabilities. To learn more, you can go to aka.ms/identity-governance-overview to learn more about how Entra ID Governance can help your organization improve productivity, strengthen security, and automate routine tasks. Thanks for your time learning about Microsoft Entra ID Governance. See you in the next video.